This is Roosevelt Gist with AutoNetwork, and we're here in Scottsdale, Arizona with Dodge for the launch of the new 2008 Avenger. And my guest on the show is Dave Lauzun, the manager of vehicle development. Dave, thanks for taking the time.
Oh, thank you. Enjoy it.
Now, why is this considered an 08 model and not an 07?
Well, we're launching this in the start of the 07 calendar year. And we decided to make this an 08 model year, which is legal to do right after the first of the year. And it's best to get it out there as a fresh new model. It actually helps with residual values as well when it's a new model year. So I want to launch it right off fresh as an 08.
Now, I'm sure you've probably heard this. I don't know whether you like it or not. This is more like a baby Charger. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Well, we wanted to have some family resemblances. I mean, we kind of view the Charger as the big brother. But the little brother has lots of its own charm and style as well. So we brought a few styling cues from the Charger, but it has its own unique pizzazz, its own unique front and rear, and a lot of unique features in it.
Now, what segment of the market will the Avenger fit in?
This is going in the huge mid-size sedan segment, one of the biggest segments out there, competing with some of the hottest-selling vehicles out there, like the Camry, the Accord, the Altima. So it's a big segment, a lot of competition.
Now, you don't currently have an all-wheel drive version, but you have one coming. Why so late?
You bet. Well, it's going to be just a few months after the initial launch of this Avenger. We'll come out right with all-wheel drive. So we just staggered the launch a bit to get the quality right on the early vehicles, and then we'll launch the all-wheel drive a few months later and make another splash in the marketplace with the all-wheel drive version.
Now, what are some of the features on the new Avenger that's going to set it apart from the competition?
We've got a lot of nice features. I'll start with our heated and cooled cup holder. This has a cup holder in the vehicle that you push a button on the console and it actually heats to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. So if you have a hot coffee in the morning, it'll keep that coffee at the perfect drinking temperature throughout your whole commute. Or if you're on a long trip and have a cool pop or water, push the cool button, it'll cool it to 35 degrees and keep it nice and chilly cold the whole trip. So great features, really enjoyable for trips or commutes.
Now, from the engineering standpoint, what are some of the pieces of equipment that sets the Avenger apart again from competition?
Equipment such as feature content?
Powertrain, features.
Oh, sure. Well, we offer three powertrains on this vehicle, which not a lot of vehicles do. We offer a 2.4-liter engine, and that's pretty standard in this market. That gets great fuel economy. And then we step right up to a 2.7-liter V6 engine. So you can get a V6 engine in this vehicle at a lower price than a lot of other four-cylinder competitors. And then for our RT model, we always like to throw the big dog at it. So we have a 3.5-liter with a 6-speed transmission that's a lot of fun, a lot of good kick to it. So three powertrains in this vehicle. And the middle one, the 2.7 liter, is also ethanol capable, E85 up to 85% ethanol content. So nice for the environment.
Now, you happened to mention something this morning in the presentation that I really wasn't aware of, and I will admit that on camera. Right. You talked about the fuel economy, the ratings. There's an old way of rating fuel economy, and there's a new way. Tell me the difference, and how does the Avenger place?
Sure. Well, the EPA decided that they wanted to make fuel economy labels on your vehicle, what's on the Monroney labels when you walk up to see a vehicle. They want to make those labels more representative of customer usage. The old EPA standards have been out there for a large number of years, and the driving test for that is set at about 50 miles an hour. So it's not very representative of today's highway driving. So they wanted to actually downgrade the fuel economy standards and make everyone's fuel economy numbers more representative. So they basically came out with a mathematical formula that takes your old 07 type numbers and scales them down a little bit in the range of 1 to 3 miles per gallon to help reflect better customer usage.
Now, how much confusion do you see that causing in the marketplace?
You know, I see some confusion for maybe a half a year to a year, and then everyone will be into 08 model year products. It'll be the norm by then, so we'll all have to get used to the new numbers. But for a few months here where you're comparing 07 vehicles to 08 vehicles, you got to be careful that all the 08 vehicles are going to be 1 to 3 miles per gallon less just because of the rating system. Nothing about the engine, nothing about the vehicle, just the rating system is bringing down the fuel economy.
Now, in terms of the options list, what are some of the options that you can get on the Avenger?
Great. Well, let me start off with some of the standard ones. I mean, we put a lot of standard features in here as well. Simple things like a sliding visor that covers up the window better. Sliding armrest, it'll slide about 2 inches forward to help make it more comfortable for shorter drivers. Dual bins in the armrest. We have a neat feature we call chill zone, which you pop open a lid in the right side of the IP, and you can actually store 4 pop cans in that chill zone. It'll blow air from your air conditioning system through that compartment and keep your pop nice and cold for the trip. So it's we tried it today on the trip, and people were very pleased with how well it works. It's a nice feature.
Now, from an aftermarket standpoint, what are some of the, pieces of equipment that Dodge will offer to kind of counteract what aftermarket consumers would like on their automobile?
Well, we have our own aftermarket brand with Mopar, and Mopar is already planning a pretty wide range of products for this vehicle. There's some wheel options, the typical ski racks and accessories for travel and trips. So there's a Mopar catalog that'll be available for the Avenger, and lots of nice features coming out from our own Mopar division.
Talk a little bit about safety features that are on the Avenger.
Great. We've counted over 30 safety features on this vehicle. Starts right off with airbags. We've got airbags galore. We have standard front multi-stage airbags. Standard side curtain airbags cover the front and the rear passenger compartments. A standard seat-mounted airbag. Lots of standard safety equipment on this vehicle. I also believe another key part of the safety equation for any vehicle is the safety cage, the body. And we put a lot of thought into this body to put the advanced steels where we need it to make this vehicle very stiff and rigid and perform very well under impact conditions.
And when will the Avenger be available for sale?
It's starting to show up in dealerships right now, right at the very first of the calendar here in January. We started shipping them to dealers, so they'll start trickling in. As we build more and more, we'll get a bigger supply of the dealerships and then make the marketing splash to help announce it to the world.
And what's been the response of the dealer body?
So far, the dealers love it. They do like keeping some of that family resemblance to the big brother, the Charger. That's been a very successful product for us. They're dying to have a very competitive midsize sedan, which this is. And they're anxious to compete head-to-head with the Camrys and Cords and Ultimas and the Ford Fusion. And it's time to have a competitive product to sell to that marketplace.
And who do you see as being the primary buyer for the new Avenger?
We have a pretty good mix of male and female, a little higher percent male for an Avenger. The Dodge attracts a little higher percent of male than our Chrysler brand does. College educated, good mid-level income, 70,000 range and such. A lot of families will be buying this car, but a lot of commuters as well because of the good gas mileage.
From a pricing standpoint, low end to high end, what are you talking about?
It starts under $19,000 and a top of the line. All-wheel drive, I believe, here's where we may have to check the numbers. I believe the top line all-wheel drive was running, I think they said up to around 32 at the highest end. But that's top of the line fully loaded, I believe.
An all-wheel drive, will that be full-time all-wheel drive?
It's an on-demand system, full-time, 100% automatic to the customer. Won't have to lift a finger. The system senses your throttle position and senses the wheel speed indicators on the vehicle, and it'll know when you need to provide more traction to one of the other wheels in the vehicle. So completely automatic to the vehicle.
And what excites Dave about the Avenger?
I love driving the RT, I admit, as an enthusiast. The RT suspension is stiffer, firmer, more pleasurable. Great performing suspension with that 3.5, 6 speed. It's just a power-packed performer. And when the all-wheel drive comes out in a few months, that's even more exciting yet because you've got extra traction on that vehicle. So it's a lot of fun.
And I know quite a few people will probably want to know two things. Will there be an SRT version with a Hemi?
Well, we don't talk about future products, but I think I can say that, you know, we are talking about it. We have had internal discussions, as we always do,
right.
You know, do we have the right product for an SRT, and what would we do to make it? So we always have those discussions and make the business case each time as to whether or not to make an SRT version of it.
Great. Dave, thanks for taking the time.
Thank you, Roosevelt. Appreciate it.
This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network, and we're here in Scottsdale, Arizona with Dodge for the launch of the new 2008 Avenger. And as always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. See you next time. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Appreciate it.